We're in Cincinnati, home of the Cincinnati Bengals at the Concrete Jungle. You know, people say this town is a real hellhole. They couldn't be more right. You know, my Goober driver almost fell into this giant sinkhole on the way to the hotel.
Hey, don't surprise me. One of Satan's favorite cities to hang in. Makes sense he's got his own highway to hell, right?
Yeah, this is going to be a bloody game. The teams are loading their weapons and sharpening their spikes. The Orcs of Hazzard battle the Cincinnati Bengals. Welcome to NFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. Welcome to NFL Sunday School, where the good playbook teaches it's an eye for no reason, a tooth for an eight ball, and a limb for just looking at me the wrong way. NFL Game Day is on the air. Grim Blitzrow, my partners Bricks and Bricks Jr. And these guys flat out want to kill each other today.
Yeah, these are the kind of games families come out to see. It's good for the sport.
You know what I like about this home team is 90% of them were born criminally insane. You can't teach that. And that was a huge run right there.
Hey, speaking of huge runs, Bricks, why don't you put a cork in that gravy maker of yours, huh? Jeez, I'm dying up here.
And it's first and 10. Quarterback passes for a touchdown. And here comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kicker.
Can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were gonna tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed, it was a chick wearing a wig.
And it's first and 10. Look out, that's an all-out attack on the... If he was still talking, he'd be saying, psycho killer, qu'est-ce que c'est?
Yeah.
What the fuck? And it's first and 10. He was stuffed at the line of scrimmage.
So was that cheerleader.
Yeah, man, I was here on the panel now. You know what I mean?
Second down and 10. That one out of the air for a first down. See,
nah, that's not fair. Someone should call a penalty on this ref.
Yeah, the death penalty. Hang them by the nuts.
I don't know what they are.
Second down and long. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down, and we've got to pick up at least half of this. Oh, he almost broke that one wide open.
Hey, speaking of breaking one wide open, who's sitting on the oil rig about to blow? Hey, smells like an oven-baked port-a-john in here. We're a freaking fracking accident waiting to happen. Don't nobody light a match.
This guy's going to get mugged in the locker room by his team after the game. No, they couldn't pick up a first down, so now they have to punt. Nice punt. Should move him back. He's got the ball now, and he's going to try and score. Oh, with the brain scrambler. And it's first and 10. And Metcalf will give them a first down.
I don't know if they're his, but he sure has a good set of hands.
And it's first and 10. Pow! And how about a little dirt sandwich? And that'll be second and 8 to go. Third down and, well, good luck. Oh, great tackle. When his brain is unscrambled, he'll be thinking about that hit.
Yeah, most likely in a convalescent home.
And it's first and 10. And the defense goes for the jugular and rushes to kill the quarterback.
I can't look. You know, they should call this play snap, crackle, and pop his head.
And it's first and 10. He's got his beast boost working. The player just transformed into a violent form of pure badass. Man, he shoveled his feet so well on that play. He should go to lost wages. And the ref is picking up a wad of singles as he runs off the field.
Didn't you see him stripping on the sidelines? He's bribed you, idiot.
And this is a first and... And they've had enough. The offense jumps off sides and attacks the ref. First down and forever. Oh, that's a vicious hit, and the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutiny.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. I personally think that the ginormous... Oh, and the defender knocked the ball out when he was in midair. It is a fumble indeed.
Fumble Banshee! From Wilton Crabtree.
Third down and 3. Sometimes the best thing to do is just punt and let your defense get the ball back.
Apparently the punter for the day is being played by my kid's sister.
Oh man, he just got skewered by those spikes. That was bloody and disgusting.
Hey, anyone in the mood for a steak kebab?
Make mine rare. And it's first and 10. It's 2 yard run before he stopped. That'll be second and 8 to go. If there were any functioning brain cells before that hit, they're gone now. He's going to have the IQ of a rutabaga after that hit. Third down and 3. And they run it for a couple of yards. And they'll line up for the punt here. And he put all of his foot into that one. He's got the ball now. Let's see what he does with it. And he's running like a moose right now.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
It's anyone's game still at this point.
I know, which makes it so hard to place a bet.
And it's first and 10.
That was a nice piece of running, Grim. That's a first down.
And it's first and 10. His balls, he is loose and headed for the end zone. He could go all the way. Well, little chip shot here, extra point, but this guy could blow it. Goes right through.
No! Like a double stop burrito from Taco Hell.
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and or bloodthirsty, whichever. No, with a punishing hit. And it's first and 10. That's a nice gain of about 7 yards on that run. Second and 3. Knocked him into the next time zone.
Once he finds his head, he'll be okay.
Third down and 3. Looks like the defense called a ginormous dirty trick. It's a whole lot of player right there.
Okay, man, I can't. Come on, get on out.
Well, here comes the punting unit. You know, punters really do know how to party, Bricks.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah, I have pictures that, well, maybe actually shouldn't discuss it. And he snags the punt and looks for open field.
I had a dog named Snags.
That, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. And it's first and 10. Nice run for 5 yards. Second down and 5. Not much there, maybe a yard. Third down and 3. It's first and 10. And they'll keep the drive alive as he rifles it in there and picks up 7 yards. Second and 3. Well, as a quarterback, you have to take risks and just chuck the ball sometimes. But it does not. Oh, and he loses the ball along with his life.
When did we become so numb to all this?
I honestly can't remember.
And it's first and 10.
Love the sound of bones snapping and cracking. I mean, when they're not your own.
And that'll be 2nd and 8 to go. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done. Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. It's good. The teams are lined up for the kickoff. Just catch it, run it back, and don't die. It's 1st and 10. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick.
If that hit didn't cripple him, it certainly left skid marks.
Second down and 7. Oh, nice hit. And it's 1st and 10. And that was a bone crusher right there, folks. First down and 7. And that's just a great run for a touchdown.
Shake your money maker, big man. You've earned it.
Hey, man, I was hitting on the middle now.
Now, there are some who would argue that we should just skip this step and make touchdowns worth 7.
What, and kick the kicker's job in half? They'd just be called shit.
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
And it's 1st and 10. He picks up 10 yards on that play. Second down, the size of Brick's wiener.
Hey!
Sorry, partner. I think the defenders are scared of this guy, Bricks, and they have every right to be.
Yeah!
First time out under 2 minutes. The chess game has begun.
It's like chess, only you can kill people.
And it's first and ten. Pow! With the brain scrambler! The quarterback is controlling the clock right now like the clock is into it.
He just clock-blocked the clock.
Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a two-minute drill. And the quarterback drills one in for the first down. First down and three.
Timeouts are kind of like condoms, you know, Grim? You got to use them smart if you want to score. Let's see if they did.
And the quarterback signals for a hurry-up offense.
Hey, Grim, what's the hurry-up offense?
There's no huddle. The offense calls plays at the line of scrimmage, and he zips that one in there for a touchdown. Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. Straight through the uprights.
No!
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chimp wearing a wig.
And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players.
Well, sure, now he catches it. I had this guy on my fantasy team last week. I lost so much money on him.
Under 2 minutes of timeout means the QB is playing beat the clock, and he better win. The offense wants to speed things up, so it signals a hurry-up.
Saban Fritz's ex-girlfriend signaled when they were doing it.
Yeah, she called it rabbit sex. I took it as a compliment.
And he held on to that one for a first down. At the end of quarter two, it's a blowout. We now go to our halftime show sponsored by Monsanto Industries, makers of great killer products like Roundup. Use it on pesky weeds or neighbors, and they'll be gone by morning. We're back for the second half in a blowout. The teams line up for the kickoff.
What a game is this close as the score indicates?
Let's see if they can keep the momentum going and keep these fans happy and, or bloodthirsty, whichever. And like a monkey trying to fuck a greased football, he gets away in a hurry. For a first down. And it's first and ten. Second down in a mile.
Can't keep a good mutant down.
That's a big gain run on that. Third down and 8.
That's the way to keep the chains moving. That was beautiful.
First and 2. And he runs it in for the touchdown.
This guy's a blowhard like the prom king of my senior prom. Thought he could be in too. I brought a zombie as my date. Man, that broad could eat. She took advantage of the $50 ahead prom ticket. I'll tell you that.
You know, this shouldn't be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. Like he just saw 400 scary movies after that hit.
Yeah, sounds like my off season.
And it's 1st and 10. And he was running like he had a load in his pants. Picks up maybe 2.
We always ran with a load in our pants, Grim. It's a pretty good defensive tool. Yeah, except the zombies. They are freaks.
Nicely done for a 1st down. And it's 1st and 10. Oh, and the defense jumps outside. This guy can talk before he died. What do you think he'd be saying, Bricks?
Psycho killer! Just to say, what the fuck?
And it's 1st and 10. There aren't too many players that kids can look.
He should apply for the Mutant Volleyball League.
Hey, don't give the fans any ideas. The commish already spends all day on Twitter shooting down rumors. 2nd down and 10. That's about a 3-yard pickup. And that'll bring up 3rd down and 7. For a kick this far, you just gotta kick it as hard as you can, partner.
And aim! It's really important from this distance.
It's probably a smart idea. The kick is good!
As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
The home team is feeling confident as they get the kickoff into the air.
Scoring makes anyone confident.
It certainly does, Bricks. It certainly does. High five! And it's 1st and 10. Offense says it's time to put the ref out of his misery. It appears that the last ref was calling his stockbroker during the huddle, and that tipped him off. It looks like he won't be buying that boat anytime soon, huh? First down and a mile. A brutal hit. And it's 1st and 10. First down. Give this guy a few catches and watch his confidence take off. He is deadly in the open field, Bricks. And it's first and 10. And he stayed with the receiver and deflected the ball. Second down and 10. Hit that was. And that's how you make a guy remember your name and your shoe size, because he just walked all over him. Third down and 10. He had it for a second there. And this field goal is certainly within the kicker's range. Kick is good. They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. About a quarter after three, Grim. Is a bit slow.
And this guy's running like an old guy looking for a bathroom. First down. And it's first and 10. Oh, man, he just laid the wood on that guy.
Yeah, if you're gonna hit a guy that hard, you should at least kill him. Do him a favor.
Finish him.
Second down and inches. That's the way to move the chains. That's good for a first down. This game is... They need to call an attack ref dirty trick and stop this or they're going to lose.
Not like they need any help with that, though, Grim. These guys are doing fine by themselves.
Second down and 10. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down and ain't going to happen, partner. Great pass on that play. They caught the defense napping. Third down and 9. Caught for the first down. The third quarter has ended, and we'll need a huge rally or a high death toll to make this one interesting. First down and 9. And he catches it for a touchdown! What a beautiful play! And here comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
No. As expected, those are pretty much just gimmies.
Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if the defense can hold them. Not a bad kick, but not a great one either.
Well, his nickname is Lukewarm.
And he's proud of that?
Yeah, that's why he named his clothing company Lukewarm Threads. Team hates it.
The offense goes into their 2-minute drill.
Well, looks like the defense handed out shrinking pills.
That's a ginormous dirty trick there, Bricks.
I guess that makes more sense.
There's ouch, that's gotta hurt. Man, those mutant traps will kill you faster than one of Bricks' farts. First and 10. Nice pickup for 6 yards. And that'll be 2nd down and 4. And they line up for the extra point. Straight through the uprights. The best kind of kick is when it's right after a score.
Hey, speak for yourself. I'm usually the one who gets kicked after scoring.
You ever get hit in the head with a boat all grim?
Nope.
Well, I have on several occasions.
Not surprising.
Multiple times on each occasion.
Not surprising.
And trust me, that hit was worse.
And the offense goes into a hurry up to pick up the pace of the game. Drills one in for the first down.
Hey, man, I was here on the panel now. You know what I have?
And it's 1st and 10. The offense is pretty much unstoppable when they use their beast boost injection. Close your eyes, Bricks. This is going to get ugly fast. Touchdown! Oh, he ran through those defenders like a greased turkey.
Hey, no game, though, man. I can't.
The offense lost another quarterback on the previous play and have only 2 left before they have to forfeit.
Yeah, but on the bright side, Wim, they save a ton of money by not having to pay those guys anymore. Other than the fuel expenses, that is.
Don't try to get fancy here. Just put the ball down and kick it.
In that order, Grim?
It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double-stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
When you get knocked down, you gotta get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
That ball just sliced through the defense like butter.
I wish defenses were made out of butter. That'd be fantastic.
And he snatches that one out of the air for a 1st down. See if they can get something going here. And it's first and 10. Oh, and the quarterback threads the needle for a first down. And it's first and 10. Hit that hard, Bricks?
Yep. Third grade. Sister Mary Margaret of Our Ladies of Holy Hell. I thought it was brass knuckles, but it was just a regular knuckles.
Second down and 5. Oh, big catch! Big run! Big touchdown!
That big deal. Mr. Meat for Brain Fam and a ball didn't fall out.
Don't want to make any mistakes here. Just kick the ball through the upright, for God's sake. The kick is good.
No. As expected, those are pretty much just guineas.
The teams are lined up for the kickoff. He's going to be able to run this one back.
I wonder if the kicker was setting up an easy kill.
And it's first and 10. And the defense goes for the jugular and rushes to kill the... Now the QB has to try to run out of bounds before they get to him. Needless to say, with 7 crazed defenders coming after him, that's not easy.
Ah, the old quarterback shellac play.
The offense is losing quarterbacks faster than teams lose their minds at spring break. They're down to their last QB before they have to forfeit. And it's first and 10. And he picks up about 6 on the play. Changes the pace by going into a hurry-up.
Does that mean the defense gets into a hurry-up, too?
Grim, did I kill him?
He dropped it. If he does that again, they'll drop him. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. A killer. It was right there, and then he dropped it.
Oh, scumbag is killing me in the fantasy league.
Ballsy? Stupid, maybe? I guess we'll decide after we see how this goes. But probably stupid.
Well, they take it to the air and pick up a 4th down conversion. I thought they were crazy to go for it.
Well, they still might be, Bricks. But crazy works in the NFL sometimes. Other times, it just comes back with a shotgun. Quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense and calls all the plays from the line of scrimmage from here on out. That, my friends, was an all-pro NFL hit. First down and 3. The offense calls a timeout. This is why you save your timeouts. You can use them in the 2-minute warning.
Now I get it. Makes sense, Grim.
Time to speed things up. The offense goes into a 2-minute drill. Well, it looks like he wanted to run before he caught it. You gotta keep your eye on the ball.
Come on, you dirtbag. You gotta make that catch.
The quarterback goes into a hurry-up offense. He's looking for a quick score.
Aren't we all, Grim? Aren't we all?
Third and 4. The quarterback is controlling the clock like the clock is into it. I know I am. When in a hurry-up offense, the offense needs to run out of bounds or take a timeout to stop the clock. And that's perfect coverage. Nice deflection. In a hurry-up offense, there is no huddle, so neither team can put their players on the bench. And he snags it for six. Touchdown! Touchdown!
Hey, how scared was Shiloh? I don't have no son.
And here comes the extra point attempt. The onside kick is a desperation play, but it's their only chance at this point to steal a position.
Steal it ain't right, Grim. It just ain't right.
Perfect kick and recovery by the kicking team. Quarterback shifts gears and goes into his hurry-up offense. Oh, that was a big hit. Hey, Bricks, I bet you took a lot of shots like that over your career.
Let's see. Yeah. About a quarter after three, Grim, but my watch is a bit slow.
First down, and the quarterback just used his final timeout. Let's see what they come up with on the next play. And the hurry-up offense wears out the defense since they can't rest their players. Perfect pass and a score! Don't make any mistakes here, or they'll kick the shit out of you in the locker room. Straight through the uprights. They'll be going onside here, and the return team is ready for it. No surprises here. First and 10. He took a beast boost injection. Now watch him stomp all over his opponents.
I want to take a beast boost injection.
Oh, he was hitting mid-hurdle and fumbles the ball. And he bursts into the end zone for the score. What a run. You know, if you go frame by frame, you can see the cover of my son's death metal album.
Yeah, baby.
Well, this should be an easy chip shot extra point, but you never know with kickers. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
Here comes the kicker.
Oh, I can't wait to hear this. What's the kicker, Grim?
This guy in the field.
Oh, I thought you were going to tell me a story like, here's the kicker. When I turned on the light, it wasn't a broad in my bed. It was a chip wearing a wig.
The Cincinnati Bengals mangle the opposition today and come away with a victory. After a stomping like that, the opposition may be a permanent part of the field.
More like a graveyard, Grim. There are body parts everywhere. And speaking of body parts, did I ever tell you?
Let's listen to the MVP. I'm sure he has something inspiring to say.